Welcome, Hoosier fans, to this Tuesday edition of Banner Morning, your daily rundown of IU basketball news and notes. I'm Jared Morris, host of the Assembly Call, and we're now just 4 days away from the Crossroads Classic. In team news, for the first time in Archie Miller's tenure, Indiana is in the top 25. The Hoosiers cracked the AP poll in a tie for 25th with Syracuse and Kansas State. The Hoosiers are 31st in the coaches' poll. In the NCAA's new quantitative ranking system, the NET, Indiana is 21st. In player news, Romeo Langford was named co-Big Ten Freshman of the Week, sharing the honor with Michigan's Ignas Brazdeikis. It is Romeo's second such honor this season. And in IU legend news, we all woke up to the tragic news on Monday morning that Eric Anderson had passed away. He was just 48 years old. No cause of death has been announced. Eric was a tremendous player who played on the first IU teams I can remember cheering for growing up. As Zach Osterman noted, Anderson remains one of just six players in IU history to rank in the top 15 all-time in both scoring and rebounding. Yet his career often gets overshadowed in large part because he was never the best player on an Indiana team. But he was always one of the most important players and trusted leaders on every IU team he played on. Eric was a McDonald's All-American out of Illinois. Then, as a freshman, he won Big Ten Freshman of the Year in a supporting role to Jay Edwards on the 1989 Big Ten Championship team. His best statistical season was his sophomore year, when he averaged 16 points and 7 rebounds, playing alongside one of the most hyped recruiting classes in IU history. As a junior and senior, Eric's numbers took a dip and his role changed, but the Hoosiers experienced great success with lineups that were filled with Hoosier legends like Calvert Chaney, Greg Graham, Damon Bailey, and Alan Henderson. The Hoosiers won the Big Ten again in Anderson's junior year, then finished second his senior year, before advancing all the way to the 1992 Final Four. He struggled that night, but had been one of Indiana's best players in the tournament up to that point, scoring in double digits off the bench in each of Indiana's first four tournament games, including a game-high 24 points against a good Florida State team in the Sweet 16. He was named the most outstanding player of the West Regional. Teammates and coaches offered words of remembrance about Eric on Monday. Two common themes emerged. One, that Eric was a great player. Two, that he was an even better teammate. Calvert Chaney summed it up like this, quote, "As a basketball player, he's one of the best I ever played with. Unselfish, caring, and did whatever it took to help us win. The consummate teammate," unquote. Rest in peace, Big E. For the links mentioned in this edition of Banner Morning, visit assemblycall.com. And remember to use the URL iutickets.shop to visit SeatGeek for the best prices on IU basketball tickets. That's iutickets.shop, promo code assembly, for $10 off your first purchase. We'll be back tomorrow with a brand new edition of Banner Morning. Until then, keep your elbows in and your eyes on the rim. And go Hoosiers.